Hello everyone, and thanks for tuning back in. Alessandro the Crypto here. I hope you're doing all fine. So what a nice morning to wake up. We had overnight, at least here in Switzerland, a nice breakout here from this consolidation wedge that we were in here in the last couple of days. We broke out as expected here to the upside, and right now Bitcoin is again consolidating here in this $12,000 range. This is the last step before we can reach to our next level of $14,000. And let's analyze if it's right now a good time to go along if you missed out here the breakout, or are we going to see here a possible confirmation that the old resistance right now, this $11,800, is now the new support? And this is why I'm telling you right now that I'm not in a trade, because this breakout happened overnight and I want to go into a long position here as soon as we have the confirmation that 11,800 is the new support. So here in the 1 hour, you can see that currently we are breaking down here from this little consolidation wedge that we were forming here, and the possible target is here 11,860. This is where I'm gonna scale in some long positions with a stop loss well below $11,800, because we could see a possible retest here before we gonna take off here and test $14,000. Our most bullish target here for this whole move is still 16,000, but the next level is 14,000. So also we have to see once we're going to reach those levels, what will happen there. But here now we are reaching a new level. We are now potentially building up support above $11,800, and this is a very bullish sign. Also, you can see here in the 1 hour, we are getting a bit overbought. So here a little pullback is very likely. Also, my indicator hit here a sell target. I wouldn't short it right now, but it looks like that we're going to have a possible retest here of $11,800. Also, looking here at the Bollinger Band, we are retracing back into the middle area here after overshooting it to the upside. MACD could have a bearish cross here if we continue here this correction. Also, stochastic shifted to the downside. So it looks like in the next couple of hours, you could get a good long opportunity if you think that we're going to break 12,000 and head towards 14,000, our next level. And now we can switch over into the 4 hour time frame, because also here you can see that my indicator hit a buy signal here, but after we had here this big pump. So that means that we will most likely see continuation here, and we are still not yet overbought. So we still have some room left to the downside. It is possible that we're gonna cool off here a little bit, retest here the new support, potentially even here the 20 moving average, which is currently also at 11,750, before we're going to take off. But the more we stay up here, of course, the higher this moving average is coming, and most likely we're gonna have here a test of $11,800 if we're going to retest and have the confirmation that old resistance is now new support. Of course, you can also start to scale in long positions if you DCA down to these levels and then just use a stop loss so you will not get liquidated. But I definitely gonna wait here, at least in the 1 hour time frame, that we're gonna cool off here a little bit, maybe test the 20 moving average here at around 11,860 before I'm gonna scale in some long entries, because now we have the confirmation that $11,800 is not any more resistance if we're gonna see a bounce from it here. And let's go back to the 4 hour and also have a look here into the Bollinger Band, MACD and stochastic, because also here we are overshooting it to the upside, and the retracement back down to the middle is very likely. And usually this is healthy when we see the price coming down, retest these levels, and then bounce again to the upside. So you're still not too late if you think that we're gonna break $12,000, because if we're gonna have this little pullback here, this is your perfect long opportunity here at $11,800. And don't forget, if you want to long short Bitcoin or any other altcoins, you can do that over on Bybit, Femex, and Bityard. You find all the links down below here if you want to register to one of these exchanges. Of course, you can also register to all of them, so you can also open up multiple trades, and on each of them you can get some sign up bonus if you use my register link that you find down below here. And now let's have a look also into the MACD, because here we had a bullish cross. So this indicates that in the next couple of hours, we will for sure see some bullish momentum to the upside. Stochastic is also coming up here very close to overbought condition. So also here, it looks like that we could see a short-lived correction to the downside and then continue here the breakout towards 12K and higher If we are getting lower than $11,800 and also start to close 1 hour and 4 hour candles below, then this could signal that we got rejected here at 12,000 and we're most likely going to head again towards 10K. But everything is still looking very bullish here, also in the lower time frames. If we go into the daily, here it looks a bit different because here we are still very overbought. So the 20 daily moving average is down here at $11,000. And also if you look at the other moving averages, they are very far away from us. Look at here, the 200 is at 8,850. So if it would reach here our bullish target of around 16,000 and then would have a correction down towards 9K, maybe even to test the 200 daily, that would be a correction of 50%. And this is what we sometimes see also during bull markets in Bitcoin. So that's why you should be prepared for all scenarios. Also, if we are starting to moon from here and also break 20K and go higher, you should have already a nice builded up portfolio, but also keep some fiat on the sideline if we're gonna see a major correction down to those levels, because this could be a perfect buy opportunity, not only for Bitcoin, but also for many other altcoins. And I don't have to mention that currently Chainlink, Band and Bancor are still outperforming everything. Especially Chainlink and Band currently are really performing great. So I'm still waiting here for a little pullback just to increase my bags that I have in there, because those coins are definitely the coins that will completely outperform everything as soon as Bitcoin is gonna break the all-time high of 20K. So after seeing that here we are getting into very overbought condition and we could expect here a pullback to retest one of these moving averages here. Also, my indicator hit it here a sell signal, but this is in the daily time frames. So for this to play out, it takes some days. And I think if we're getting rejected here at 12K, we're gonna see a complete correction down to those levels and possibly also cool off all the indicators, because currently we are very overbought. And also if we go over into the Bollinger Band in the daily, you can see that here we are still trading in the upper area. We still have some room left to the upside towards 12,630. But also here, in case that we are retracing back to the middle line, this would be here at 11,000. And if we would lose 11,000, then I think first we're going to have maybe some little bounces here at around 10,500 before we continue the correction down to possibly $9,400 area. This would also close the CME gap that we have down below at $9,600. Also, the MACD is looking a bit toppy here. So I think as long as we are still shifted to the upside, we should be good to go. But as soon as here in the daily, we're going to have a bearish cross, this could indicate a major correction. The good thing is that the stochastic currently is still oversold. So here we have a lot of room left to the upside. So this is what is a bit surprising me right now, because the stochastic is completely oversold and we are building up momentum here to possibly also break through this $12,000 quite huge, because the next target would be then around 14,000 and this is a $2,000 increase. All right, and before we also have a look into the weekly time frame, let's have a quick look here in the CMEs, because as you can see, we also have now a new CME future gap down here at 11,645. If you go into the 1 hour, we can see it better. So during the weekend, we had this jump here and the CMEs didn't close yet this gap. So now we have two gaps below of us. And as you can see, although if we zoom out here a little bit, this rising wedge here, which also could end up here in this big rising channel here, we are still technically in this rising wedge, which could break out still to the downside. And the target first would be down here at 11,500. And if we're going to break out here from this rising channel to the downside, then of course we could go and fill all the gaps that we have also down below here. So I'm keeping an eye here, especially on the CME's chart, what is going on right now, because here it looks like that because of these two CME gaps and also this formation that we are building up right now could indicate that we will see a major correction pretty soon. So also here you see how important it is that we're going to break here this $12,000 area. If we are getting into our next target of around $14,000, then we would be out of this pattern. And then I think this would be the absolute confirmation that we will go even higher. And now let's go back into the Bitstamp chart and let's open up the weekly time frame, because also here you can see that we are still far away from our moving averages, same like in the daily time frame. The 20 weekly right now is at our previous resistance here at $9,700. This is where also our new support is lining up in case that we're gonna see here a major correction to the downside. And also here, of course, we are very overbought. If we go over into the Bollinger Band in the weekly, also here you can see that we're still overshooting it to the upside. So retracement back down into the middle area here of around $9,400 is still in the cards. And also MACD and stochastic here are getting overbought. Only if we go into the really big time frames, like into the monthly, then we are still looking like that we could have a lot of room left to the upside. And that's why here the big time frames here, like the monthly, are still looking great. So for the long term, Bitcoin is going to outperform everything, and we should be still very, very bullish and buy every bigger correction that we're going to see here in the next couple of weeks and months if we're going to correct hard. Here we have the RSI still in neutral condition. Even in the crash in March, we had the RSI just bouncing here from the 50 level. So we never came into like a bear market or anything like that. Only here in the crash of 2018, we had here a little dip below the 50 in the RSI, but then immediately recovered back up, which is very, very bullish. Also, you can see here my indicator gave here a buy signal once we broke out from the 20 moving average in the monthly. So since then, it was every day a good buy opportunity, and always will be. And yeah, with that said, guys, I think I can wrap it up for now. If something crazy is going on, I will bring an update video. So make sure to subscribe to the channel. And also, if you have Discord, you are very welcome to join our free Discord trading chat. The invitation link is down below here. And if you have Twitch, you're also very welcome to join my Twitch channel. So I think we're ready to go, my friends. Don't forget to register to any of these exchanges here if you want to trade Bitcoin and other assets up to 100x leverage, where also with small amount of money, you can do big gains. So don't forget, subscribe to the channel, moon up the likes. Thank you very much for your support, and we're gonna see us all in the next one. Bye.